trouble. I can't be short. I'll be an outcast like Rudolph the Uncircumcised Reindeer.
Look, Rudolph, it's not me, all right? It's Dasher. He's been complaining, and he is the one who has to look at it all night.
I don't know. Mrs. Claus says it'll decrease my sensitivity.
I'm sorry, why are you talking to my wife about this?
Hey guys, do you like beer but can't get drunk from beer? Then try new vodka beer. The can says beer, but inside is 12 ounces of carbonated vodka. And the best part is, your wife will never know.
Honey, I'm so proud of you, cutting down to one beer a night.
Take off your underwear. She don't know.
All right, I'm off to the fish market.
What? Why?
Well, the most intimidating people are toothpick guys who work at seafood counters and make people uncomfortable for not knowing about fish.
What's good here?
It's all good.
What's the freshest?
It's all fresh.
How about the halibut? Is it gamey?
Gamey?
I mean, you know, is it fishy?
It's all fish.
Is there a special way to prepare it?
I'd cook it up.
Well, what's the best fish here? What's your favorite fish?
I don't eat fish. I only like spaghetti.
He's got a padlock on here. But don't worry, I'll figure something out.
Well, hurry, because I'm trapped like a baseball announcer.
And the count is 2-2. Garcia steps off the mound, again, virtually guaranteeing that my wife will be asleep when I get home. The big right-hander kicks a little dirt and tosses the rosin bag as my children grow up without me. Okay, and now a fan in the stands is giving me the finger. I agree. Hey, I don't know if you can hear it, but I'm peeing in my coffee cup right now.
Can we watch the thing now?
Of course. Here it is. The last episode of Winter Summer.
Oh my God, this is everything I've dreamed of. Well, this and becoming a half-man, half-horse. Give up these legs? Don't be absurd.
Dear me, they're really disappointed in me, Rupert. I haven't seen the fat man this upset since he went to the 9/11 museum.
Lois made us do this, but I wanted to go to the Central Park merry-go-round.
We had time to do both!
Oh, man, apps sound awesome! This is a real game-changer. Like the guy who invented wearing a sport jacket with jeans.
So, what can I do for you?
Well, I've got to go to church, but I don't have time to change from the rodeo.
Excuse me, I thought you were helping me find a look that'll let me cling to my youth in my 40s.
Yes, I'm interested in cheating on my wife in Las Vegas.
Gentlemen, I think I can help all three of you.
Look at his face. He looks like Oliver Platt climbing a flight of stairs.
Hey, that's a low blow. I'm gonna call the network and complain. Where's the phone?
It's upstairs, Oliver.
Yeah, they know what they did.
Couch it is, I guess. Oh my God, the couch is gone. Where the hell is... Oh, that's right. Couchella is this weekend.
Hey, man, where you been?
I just had sex with a girl on her period.
Dude, that's not a brag.
Peter, I think we should send Stewie to Corridors. I know it's a little pricey, but it's the best preschool in the area.
Really? Is that the one where they make him dress in the little shorts and hats like the guy in AC/DC?
Yeah, why does he wear that outfit?
Because he rocks.
When I picked this, I didn't know I'd have to wear it when I'm 60. I'm very cold.
You're right. Poor Tom. Thanks to me, he's fallen even further than Charlie Rose.
Today on CBS This Morning, we'll be talking about how much sleep you need to not be drunk from the night before.
That's not what we're talking about.
That's what I'm talking about.
Well, I have to admit, you two do make a cute couple. But then again, so did Chris Martin and Gwyneth Paltrow.
Do you take this woman to lecture you about trans fats for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And do you take this man to be a watered-down Bono until death do you part?
I do.
I now pronounce you pretentious and terrible. You may name your daughter after a fruit.
What? Drugging a baby?
Are you sure? That sounds so serious.
I'm afraid his behavior has been an issue for a while. He's even been bothering students during nap time.
Hey, you up? Guess where I have a crayon.
Wow, this is easier than getting your jet ski license.
All right, Kyle, looking good. You got 100% on your written test, 100% on your water test. Just one last question. Have you ever had a fist fight with your stepdad?
Which stepdad?
You passed! Here's your license. Go be a dick.
I thought you were this worldly, sophisticated guy, but you're just a fraud, like Moses.
And the Lord's 11th commandment, Moses gets to be first in line at the buffet.
What? Oh, seriously?
I know, you guys, it's so lame, but that's what it says.
Get in the car.
What? Why?
You'll see.
Why should I trust you? You're always tricking me into going places I don't wanna. Oh, You said we were going to a place Walt Disney built.
No, Peter, I said supported. By the way, don't go on the train ride.
Oh, how'd you get him so quick?
That was easy. Like pressing that easy button at the office supply store.
Hey, thanks for all your help.
No problem. Why don't you go ahead and hit the easy button?
Okay. What did I just do?
Don't worry about it.
God, what a nightmare. That guy's even scarier than a thesaurus-a-saurus.
Tread, stomp, trudge, growl, roar, ululate, antonym, whisper.
What's wrong with him?
He's on the spectrum.
Spectrum? In my day, we'd throw him in the army and have him play the bugle.
Look, I'm sorry, but my mom said he can't be left alone at home anymore. Last time he went crazy and moved all the furniture around.
Dancing, walking, rearranging furniture. Babs is shopping. I let the bird out of the cage.
Because just sitting here all sober is more boring than watching a pot boil.
Hey, you.
What are you doing?
I like to watch. I want to watch you boil.
I can't do it with you watching.
Oh, not even if I do this?
Don't do that. Oh, God, it's so hot.
Oh, yeah? Then why don't I take your top off?
Oh, I'm boiling. I'm boiling.
Yeah, now I'm going to stick my raw pasta in you.
Peter, what's going on in there?
Making dinner, babe.